What's going on, fellow collectors, kids of all ages? It's been a while since I put up a video, so today, in this video, I am doing the Man of Steel 1/3 scale Prime 1 Studio. And it's pretty nice, totally different from the half scale. And you look at the, to your left on the video, you'll see the Sideshow Collectible Superman there, and he's premium format. Down below in front of the 1/3 scale, you'll see the Hot Toys, the new Man of Steel. And all the way in the bottom there, you'll see the McCallum 12 years. So there's a little size comparison of all of them. Shit, that half scale, I forgot how heavy it is, but it's beautiful still, nevertheless. I will go through the pros and cons of the 1/3 scale Prime 1 Studios outfit, and also the base. Pros and cons, a couple of things I don't like with the 1/3 scale, and then everything else is magical on it. So let's get right to it. Alright, so let's get on with the review. I'm going to go with the cons first. I got a few of them, and then we'll go into the pros. Now, in no way, shape, or form am I knocking the figure for anyone that has collected it. This is just things that are wrong with mine, and it could be wrong with all of them. I have not seen everyone's, I mean, a lot of reviews out there yet from this statue. But firstly, I want to just say that if you have it, congratulations, and if you don't, if you want it, you're on the fence, you should get it. And thirdly, if you do have it, don't listen to me and start nitpicking. Yeah, I'm just like a little bit of a perfectionist, especially at this price point. So it's just the way I feel about it. You know, I'm pretty honest with what I have, and especially when I tell it on video to the community. Whoever watches the video, I just want you to get the right impressions of how I feel about the statue. Now, let's go into the cons. I have the half scale, and very fortunate to pick that up at the time, and I remember paying monthly for that until it came out. So I'm very happy with it. I'm ecstatic with it. But looking at this one, first, if you don't have the half scale, you're not gonna know what I'm talking about, but the half scale texturing is more rubber on that half scale than this. This feels like a cheaper quality of fabric. So right off the bat, I was not happy with this. Feeling it, I don't feel that rubber texture. It's, you know, it's there, but it's not, you know, it's not that rubber texture that I have in the half scale. So it's a little bit higher, a better feel, excuse me. It's just a better feel, a better texture, I feel that that fabric is. Okay, this is the big one. This is real big. This is bigger than the cape issue. On mine, the crotch area, which I'll give you a close-up, goes across the seam, then it goes up, and then it goes back into the hip area where the seam is hidden. You'll get a close-up, and it goes all around the body of the waist. So my symbol, or the buckle, is up on one side and straight on the other side. So that's a pain in the ass. And also the incorrection, the way they sewed here, it's up. And I can't pull it down to straighten it because it is sewn, incorrectly. So that's a problem. So that's the reason why I call Sideshow and I want to return on this statue, on this particular body. I want my shit to be straight. I can deal with anything else, but that is an eyesore, so I can't deal with it. Then the other problem is the cape. Cape comes, everyone has this problem, it comes super wrinkled. That's an easy fix, an iron. But the lengthwise, on the half scale, it is perfect. It is just right close to the bottom of the heel. Just a fraction could be dragging, but that's where it's supposed to be. It's not supposed to be that long. I don't care what you say. That's not the way the cape should be. He's not supposed to be fucking sweeping the floor with his cape, I think. oh, I don't remember, I'm gonna go look at the 2013 movie, and I'm gonna look at the other movies. I can't remember if he's really, or it could have been changed. You know, for this scene, we'll have a longer cape. For that scene, we'll have a shorter cape. You know, I don't know, but I don't like it. I'd rather have the half scale look where it's just right here, perfect, you know, perfect height on the body, and it just doesn't look like a fucking curtain in Radio City Music Hall where it's just dropping down. Don't like it. So that's my problem, I know. But maybe I'll have that corrected by a seamstress in the neighborhood where I live here in New York. And that's it. That's basically my problems. I'm not gonna go with the abs because I looked at the half scale. Half scale is much more symmetrical, much more cleaner. This one's like a little like bumpy. His rib cage is sticking out, way out. I see the rib cage. Why is this so pronounced through the outfit? I have no idea. But maybe because it's still supposed to be tight and that's the rib cage here. I don't like the rib cage. I mean, it's enough with the abs that are sticking out and then the upper rib cage here and then all the abs and the rib. Anyway, I'm rambling. Oh, and the base. That fucking ugly color. I know it's supposed to be like the ship and, you know, and all that shit going on, but damn. Can you give me some more, like, now put some effort into it. It's just like, made it, blocked it, duplicated, couple of coats, and that's it. I like that fucking S up for that price, you know what I'm saying? Do something. You know, I did get, this is exclusive with the head. Anyway, let's get some close-ups, and that's enough venting for this video. Alright, so let's look at the base. This is a close-up of the front of the base. And there's the keyhole. There's one, that's where his foot gets set in to that. It's really secure, it's really nice. Then you have, like, you know, rivets going around the ass area. And looks pretty cool, you know. But it's a generic paint, man. It's just like rock form, you know. Those tentacles. You know, really, yeah, I got a little bit of piping working here. You see that? I mean, you know, gee whiz. It's a nice, nice big base. But I need more depth in it, you know? Paint should have been awesome on this. So gray, so like, yeah, blah. Let's look at the bottom of it. I'll lift it up for you. There you go, Justice League. 203 out of 350. That's basically it. Does it have a couple pounds into it? Probably, I don't know, 10, 11 pounds. Nothing major. But yeah, I'm a little disappointed with the base. You know, I'm totally disappointed with the goddamn statue. But what are you gonna do? Let's move on. So here you have the regular head sculpt. I know it looks like it's glistening. There's the regular head sculpt. Looks nice, decent. Colors on it, the likeness is there, the 5 o'clock shadow. Looks pretty good. The eyes look pretty straight, right? Not too bad. Ears, the hair proportion. There's the neck. And there are the two slots for the cape. I took the cape off. The S shield. There's the texturing on the outfit. It does look on camera like the half scale of Prime One if you guys have it. And if you don't have it, then you know you're not gonna understand what I'm talking about, the texturing. But you see the armpits? See that length? See how long they are all the way down? Not normal. Should be tighter, should be more should be more contour or tight to the wings, your lats. You know, and your upper armpit. So I don't know what the fuck happened there. I'm sorry for effing, but that's the truth. The hands are really nicely painted as well, as is the head, very lifelike. So here's my belt problem. So you see the stitching there? See how it goes up, and then the buckle looks crooked. Okay, so that's my problem. And there's the crotch area, the thighs, boots. All right, and let's take a look at that beautiful angry head sculpt. So if you guys get the exclusive, you'll get this head sculpt. I'm gonna keep the regular version. Reminds me more of like the zombie, you know. But like, you know, there's the heat vision, eyes, nicely painted. Yeah. Really looks good. All right, so here's the back of this big boy. Now, if you're a Superman fan, I mean, if you like Henry and do you like the, you know, you like Superman and you want this part of your collection, definitely is a, you know, statement to have this. You know, it really looks awesome. But does have a couple of flaws. I mean, or some, you know, some things that are, everyone's gonna have, which is this. You know, that's his lats, but that looks pretty cool. You know, from the back. But from the front, it doesn't look good. And, I don't know. That's how it is. But it's a nice texture. It's a nice outfit. Again, one more time, one more pass. And then we'll get this cape back on. So you guys can take a look at that. Now, very easy to put the cape into the slots. You have these little metal triangular guides there sewed onto it, so it just slips into the holes and fits perfectly, no problem. There is no S on the back of this cape, and lengthwise it's really longer than the actual statue, and of course ours comes wrinkled. I guess they tried their best on it to not have it wrinkled. They wrap it with a cardboard, but it didn't come out that way when I opened my box. Before I add cape to it, I just wanted to show you the very impressive, the heel and the back of the right foot that's off the actual base, which is a nice touch. They could have just put him flat-footed, but they did him, you know, because he has his right leg back and it's like he's moving, he's walking, so that gives it that illusion, but it's very, very nice. The bottom of the boot really painted well. Reminds me of the Iron Man color. And the other boot. There's the nice front. And they did a great job on the boot. Now, how long this fabric is gonna last, I have no idea, but I hope until I die. So this will be my collection. It's nice texturing. Nice job they did on the boots. Just wanted to share that with you guys. Alright guys, in conclusion here, this video, I'm going to end it with... I like the statue. I'm happy with it. I can't tell you that I'm not. I just wish it didn't have a couple of those faults in it. But if you're a first-time Superman fan, you know, where you don't have one this scale, and, you know, this is out there for you, by all means, get it. If you like, you know, Henry, and you like the Man of Steel, this is a great piece to have in the collection. I'm pretty, pretty stoked with it. I didn't show you guys the Mother's Box, which is down here. It's part of the accessory. And the exclusive, of course, is the extra head sculpt, the angry version, the heat vision. For the accessory, I really don't care for it too much, because the fact is that it's really a useless piece. What am I going to do with it? You know, if you're not a Superman fan, you haven't seen the movie, and I keep it next to him, people are going to just ask me, say, oh, what the hell is that? You know, is that a Hellraiser box? You know, and no, it's not. So basically, I could do without it. And also, the heat vision could do without it as well. If you guys needed you could buy this and not get the exclusive, you'll be fine with it. You can live without it. Believe me, it's not something that you gotta go and say, wow, I gotta have it, you know? And the accessory as well, that box is bullshit. But the statue itself, it's pretty impressive. The likeness is awesome. The eyes, I love it. I really love the head sculpt. The body stuff is a problem with the uniform, or the outfit, but you know, everything else is cool. I can deal with the cape. For the price point, I'm a little still upset because should be better. Should be a little bit better. They should have taken care of the quality control. Anyhow, with that said, thank you for watching the video, and sorry I haven't been out with a video for a while, but I shall have some more pieces coming in soon. And you know how I always say, I know you don't like me, but you like my style. Peace.